Hello and welcome back, guys. This is Frost here, and we're playing MLB The Show. We just beat the Philadelphia Phillies to end a losing streak. We're going to advance our day. We got the Twins at home. They're a pretty good team. We got Brandon Fatt and Anthony Descovani going together. Let's go City Connect. I like City Connect. They're my favorite type of uniform, really. Let's go Rain and Closed. Everyone had a good day off. Let's see, we got Righty on the mound. We'll go ahead and just roll with everyone else as is. See what's going on here. Ooh, Marte's down to the 200s. Jock's down to the 200s. Thomas and Moreno, I understand, but yeah.
And welcome in, everybody. Glad you're with us. Interleague Baseball.
So, back
right,
home.
Ready to go here. And now for the
like,
Twins.
The thing is, Edouard, like, Interleague Julian. Baseball doesn't even, like, mean anything anymore.
On the ground. And it finds its way through for a hit. Man aboard
because,
on a leadoff single.
Like, really nice when you have the DH, it meant something because, you know, the Twins come to Arizona. Arizona has to, you know, Twins have to, pitchers have to,
in the dirt, but kept close. Blocked by
have
the
to
catcher,
bat now.
And he steals second base without a throw.
Go to Minnesota, and the Dbacks have to find a DH. Like, those are the things, that's what made Interleague play so cool.
And that's the strikeout looking. Buckled in with the backdoor breaking ball for strike three. Here's Royce Lewis. Ball. Pitch misses there, and that's ball two.
Hitter's got some good opposite field power. What I like about one. Something being hit to the right side into the
he is safe.
Oh, he was out.
One away with a runner at third. And we're just getting started here in the top of the first. And ball four to aboard. Here's Byron Buxton. Got him. Huge strikeout there.
Well, that was such a great opportunity to grab
my man's
lead.
Batting cleanup at 162.
All you got to do is just put the ball in play on the ground, and you drive across a run. It's a frustrating.
I don't know why I did that.
So we take a break.
I don't know why I threw it home instead of just going to the bag, but whatever.
Left-hand hitter waits.
Got lazy.
To third.
Was it? It was like All-Star Baseball. I had it for the GameCube, I think, and if you fielded the ball as a first baseman and hit whatever Dreamcast had, B button, I assume it was B button maybe, whatever they had on the right side, the first base button, and there was no one there, he would just toss the ball to no one. So I think I still have like some leftover trauma from that.
Keeps you on your toes all game long because you got to make plays for your pitcher on the defense, and so an offense like that can really put some pressure on that defense. So they can swing the bats, put it in play, but I also think if they run the bases hard, it adds another element to their game.
You rewind and think back to those Giants teams that won three world titles. They were pretty good contact-based teams. Obviously, the Royals as well. It feels like it's swinging back a little bit towards there's an advantage to having some hitters in your lineup that make contact. Next to hit for Arizona, Christian
Walker.
Oh, it's early.
Could have crushed that shit.
Two outs, bases empty. And a swing and a miss. And that's that.
This guy finds good, apparently.
Back here in the desert. Now Correa up to hit. And a pitch.
He plays the Twins now? Interesting. Well, he was still in
the pitch. Not even close there. Ball two.
I'm old enough to remember when Houston was still in the National League.
Swings through that one. It's a strikeout.
Jeff Bagwell.
Just a mid-90s challenge fastball right there. Not much to it. And I'm sure he'd love another swing at it because It was in a very hittable location. Those are the swings where
they must have made an update or something, because these guys are. There's no way I was getting through this.
And it's 2-2.
For whatever reason, this is a hitter that performs better in night games. We'll see what he brings in this one.
He
struck him out swinging.
And Brandon Fatt ain't that good.
Two outs, bases empty. Matt Wallimer, the next twin up to hit. A dive, he's got it. And they get the out.
See, in that case, he would have just thrown it to the bag.
Excellent stop right there.
Either no one's there instead of running it.
Waves the pitcher off and continues to run into the dugout.
I don't think he actually waved the pitcher off. He just got up and ran.
Back here at James Field, bottom of the second.
They need to add into the game.
Jack Peterson stands in.
Late on everything, that sinker is fucking fast.
Ground ball right side.
Right into the shift.
Whips it to first. That's one out, the bottom of the second. And it's Lourdes Gurriel Jr.
Oh, a well-thrown slider like that one can be tough to get in the air. Good downward break on that one.
There's a strike. One out, base is empty.
This is fucking dominating. First and AL, too.
Lifted in the air, right field. Should have this one. He makes the
jammed
catch.
Him.
And there's two down. Geraldo
jammed him.
Stands in now for the Diamondbacks.
Throwing outside, yeah.
So a foul ball makes it 1-2.
Hold on. Okay.
The shortstop takes the ball. The middle. Oh, great stop.
Throws oh, come on.
Knees. It's there, and that's a great play. And welcome back to the ballpark.
I mean,
well,
I
here we go.
Throw
top
no hitter
of the third
weeks.
Scoreless game. Here's Trevor Larnach out towards right center field. Carroll moving under it. Makes the grab. One up, one down. Back to the leadoff spot in the Twins lineup. Here's the second baseman, Edouard Julien. Next offering is in for a strike.
I don't know, man.
Popped up to the left into foul ground. Suarez
all of a sudden
pulls
here.
It down and there's two gone. Here's Alex Kirilov. Two down, nobody on.
Having back-to-back decent pitching.
Put in the knees for a strike. Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout. Down goes. Set for the bottom of the third. Eugenio Suarez up to the plate now. The 1-1. Fouled off. He was late.
Gino Suarez. Gino Juarez. Oof.
1-2 now.
No, huh?
Swing and a fly ball in the air out towards down. Right center field. Flashes the leather on the running catch.
So bad.
And there's one down. And now the center
so
fielder,
bad.
Alec Thomas. And that's,
ball,
outside.
That's outside.
And it's 2-1.
Inside? Coming inside? No.
Swing and a high fly ball down the left field line, but hooking foul.
I mean, he's hitting better than McCarthy right now, so I'm going to do that in.
Next pitch misses.
Ooh, that was close as fuck.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Ripped to short. Throw
oh,
it off the bag and he's safe.
That's a play you expect your shortstop to make pretty much every time. Pretty routine. Hard to tell if he didn't get a great grip on it or the mechanics on him just broke down, but that gives this offense an extra out to work with.
Thomas at first, one gone. Out of line, out towards center. And there's two down.
Yeah. Couldn't do it, man. just couldn't do it.
So the batting order turns over. Here's the Diamondbacks leadoff hitter, Corbin Carroll. That misses the zone. 2-2. Two gone, but the go-ahead run is at first. Here in the last half of the third. Runner takes off. Throw to second.
Oh, he was safe. That's horseshit.
And we're back. John Chomby with Chris Singleton. And set to lead off the fourth, Royce Lewis. And that one a little below the knees. And it's 2-1.
I'm with you guys. I thought that was a strike.
Righty to the plate. And that one missing low.
Wow.
Gets a piece there. We'll do it again.
Looked like you got a little excited on that fastball. Got to think to yourself, I want to stay up the middle. That way, if you're a little bit early, you hit it out of the ballpark. You're a little late. Opposite field now.
Falls it in for the out.
Oh, I thought it was on the ground. I ran to first base.
The next twin up to hit. Right-hander kicks, deals. Swing and a tapper that rolls foul.
And we're just doing straight up, like,
and a pitch.
Pitching battles tonight.
Hit by him for the K.
Came inside with that two-strike fastball nicely and just bunched him up on the inside part of the plate. Couldn't get around on it and catch it out front. Many times if you do, it's a foul ball.
Oh, come on.
You know, a lot of pitchers, they really don't like working inside with two strikes because they do not want to hit that batter. And when they've got him up against the ropes, got to figure out a way to put him.
This one's into the outfield. Could be extra bases. And he's in at second with a two-out double.
Well, his hot hitting continues. He's been getting great results lately. Anytime you can drive a ball into the gap the other way, it feels so good.
Now, this ball is well hit. This one's got a chance. Makes the catch up against the wall.
Close.
Corbin Carroll.
3-1, taking the pitch, no matter what happens.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, we call that key holding. Even though it's right there and looks pretty good, if he doesn't love it, he's not going to swing that early in the count.
Now the throw to first on the run. Not in time, and he reaches safely.
Well, he did all he could at short to try to make an amazing play and almost got it done. But good hustle down the line, and that
rudder takes off, pitches low.
Why would you stop?
Tries to get back and save.
Why are you stopping?
Man, is he fast.
That is so fun to watch.
Carroll on at first. Nobody out. DeSclafani checks the runner. Carroll back in standing.
DeSclafani.
Base runner with a one-way lead right there. All he's trying to do is get a look at the pitcher's move. Had no intent of stealing on that pitch.
Runner goes again. That one's sizzling on its way through to the outfield. Okay. And now runners at the corners.
That's got to be
it.
That's got to be it. Error, right?
A pretty high leverage spot right there. Pretty tough for the infielders to do anything with that one. He pulled it hard into the outfield. And even
that's right by his glove.
It feels great when you hit a missile like that.
So runners at the corners. Nobody out. And here's the first baseman, Christian Walker. That's outside, and a count 2-1. DeSclafani throws to first. Marte back easily. The Diamondbacks with a chance to score first here in game one of this three-game set. A little out front there as he swings through it.
Two balls, two strikes.
Outside again?
Swings and misses, struck him. But no advance from the runners. Two on, one out. Here's Jack Peterson. Ground ball right side, could be two. Over to Correa for one. Return throw to first, got him. Double play.
Couldn't do that with Walker.
And now the right fielder, Max Kepler. Pitch misses. 2-1.
Well, these Twins doing a great job, Boog, of just waiting for the right pitch to come their way, and I'm seeing very patient at bats out of them. They haven't produced a run yet.
You say that, but
for the starter, I mean, starting to still climb, so they're hoping that starts to pay off.
Zero.
That one misses. 3-2 now.
And I think they're in a good spot thanks to their pitching, but no one would be shocked if this offense strings something together to take the lead.
Outside, and that is ball four. Matt Wallner, the next twin up to hit.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
Makes the grab, one down. Now the left fielder, Trevor Larnach.
Trevor Larnach.
Here's a 1-1.
Yeah.
He's been very consistent with his command out there on the mound, consistently throwing at the knees. Pretty impressive when a guy can repeat his delivery like this.
All tied up, and we're at the top of the fifth.
Yeah, that
hammered,
was
and now maybe
a
extra
mistake
bases.
Pitch.
Kepler around second, headed for third, headed for the plate. Relay throw home. He'll score. The Twins have the lead. 1-0.
Well, a swing like that can help you come out of the struggle. We saw the numbers coming into the ball game, but all he's trying to do at this point is help his team win.
Now here is Edouard Julien.
Dbacks haven't been able to take advantage, man.
And there's two away.
Dbacks have had runners on third with at least one out, maybe two outs, a couple times.
Two outs and one in scoring position. Next offering is in for a strike.
I've had a runner on third. The runners on corners, no outs, and
that one lifted
had
to
a
left.
Runner on third,
Gurriel
one
trying
or
to get
two
there.
Outs at least.
And that is that.
In this situation, couldn't get
but
a single
run,
run home.
But a run will score in the inning on this RBI double.
So,
bottom of the inning.
That's not pitching
bad.
Here's
the left fielder, Lourdes Gurriel Jr. On the ground to third. Zips it to first, and the leadoff man set down in their half of the fifth. And now, Geraldo Perdomo.
Deceptive slider right there. Stayed in the tunnel a long time. Got that hitter out front. Rolled over it. Put it on the ground.
And the righty deals. In the air out to center. And that'll fall for a base hit. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Hitting is really easy for some guys. One thing that I can see already, his bat stays in the zone on plane for an extended period of time. And guys like that, they have a high contact rate and they have more barrels because of that bat being on plane. And even when you don't get it great, it's still hit hard enough to dunk something in like that in front of the center fielder.
Runner on the move. Swing and a miss. Safe and second with a stolen base. Next up for the Diamondbacks, Alec Thomas. At the belt and fires. That one down the line. Has some trouble with it. And that'll put runners at the corners with two away.
Well, that may end up being an attack. We
guessed it.
Later on when this game is over.
Hey, Gabby.
We'll be back coming up here. Looking for a way to get that tying run across with two outs.
That's the ball.
Next pitch is outside.
3-1.
Honestly, if you want to walk me, I'll take it.
The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
Pitch count's getting up there now, and not saying that's the reason for this walk, but
like
this
Corbin.
Is the point in the game when every sign of wavering starts to get everyone's attention.
Perdomo at third, Thomas at second, Moreno on at first with two down. On the ground to the left, down the line, and it's foul. Hit pretty well in the air out to center. Buxton sizes this one up, squeezes it, and that will end the inning.
Runner on third, two outs.
And welcome back to the ballpark.
Get them.
Top six. And now for the Twins, Royce Lewis.
Now my man's gonna have 9,000 foul balls.
That one 95 finish him off.
Oh, you know that's gotta be very frustrating for this guy.
That
he knows the strike zone extremely well. And you know what? Good hitters are not gonna compromise. He'll take that punch out, but ultimately stick with his plan and have more success than anything else.
Hard hit left side. fires over to first. Two quick outs to open the top of the sixth.
Oh, we talk about how the ball is coming out of a pitcher's hand. The way it comes out of his hand as an infielder. Wow, really impressive.
Ryan Jeffers at the plate. Two outs. And there's a curve through for a strike.
Drop that curve has been a big pitch for him today. He's been able to get ahead in the count with it. He's also been able to use it to put guys away.
Brings it in for the third out.
Gotta get some hits, guys. Gotta get some hits.
Inning. Ketel Marte up to the plate. The 1-1. And fouled off. The 1-2. And another ball. In the air to left center. Pulls up, there and that's go. In there for a knock.
I'll take it.
And now, Christian Walker. And a 2-1 on the way. That's a slider for a strike.
Well, here's a good opportunity in this inning to get on the scoreboard after that leadoff hit, and Harvey Order coming up right behind them. This is where they need to get going.
Now a screamer into the outfield. Buxton pulls it in on the run.
Almost 100 pitches through 5 1/3 innings. I'm thinking he's probably done in the next couple of batters.
And next is the designated hitter, Jock Peterson. And he deals. Gets the call. 2-2 now. The kick and the pitch. Runner goes. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. With the tying run on at first here in the bottom of the sixth. Runner on the go again. Swing and a chopper. Julian throws that's to that. First in time. Yep. No chance at the double play, but the runner
in motion.
Brock Stewart taking over on the mound.
Well, walks have been a big issue for him this year, so I expect these hitters to be patient up there.
Runner edges away at second.
That's the ball.
Next offering misses down and away.
This hitter's looking for a fastball, but I'm not sure he's going to get one. Pitcher doesn't have to challenge him. If he feels better about his off-speed secondary stuff, then stay with it.
With the tying run at second, you're in game one of this three-game set. That misses the zone, and it's 3-2. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
You said that guy's
second.
Bad at keeping.
Now up next for Arizona, Geraldo Perdomo.
Ball in the strike zone.
That one finds the zone. Going to count 1-2. Some movement in the Twins bullpen. Obi Milner warming up for manager Rocco Baldelli. Topa getting cranked up as well.
2-2.
And that's outside.
Do you want to throw down?
I struck him out of the foul.
He said as I strike out. I'm getting guys in the scoring position. Just can't get the RBI.
Pitch
that
misses, and it's 2-1.
2-1.
Have a left. Let's go Graveman. He's got a lot of pitches.
Swing and a miss as he was late that time.
2-2.
Bounce to the right. Marte sends it to first. That takes care of Correa. Now batting Max Kepler.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Base is empty, one away.
Here in the top half of inning number 7.
And a swing and a miss. And to a layup.
Really love the pitch sequence right there. I'm telling you what, pitcher and catcher on the same page right now.
Matt Walmer, the next twin up to hit. So now 1-2.
Yeah, something must have changed because these guys are swinging through fucking everything.
Yeah, that's too high.
It's a good take.
Two down, nobody on. Strike three, got him with the backdoor
nice
breaking
pitch.
Ball. Nothing doing. We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom of the seventh. Justin Topa.
Well, home runs have been a problem this year. Not doing a great job keeping the ball in the yard so far this season. So we'll see if that factors in.
Well, one run game. Eugenio Suarez stands in now for the Diamondbacks.
Early. Fucking early. He's got a slider further down the way. Or outside. Yeah.
Line, and that's a base hit. Off to a good start with a leadoff knock.
He was all over that one. Solid swing from start to end. On time with everything. Really good balance. Nice extension. And he met it out front for the line drive knock.
Julian to second for one. How about that double play?
I think he was safe. Give me a look.
You don't really get to appreciate all of the finer details of how these guys execute. Right there, really nice footwork and a good feed to second.
I'm right on it. What more do you want from me?
And that is the...
What more do you want from me?
Back here at Chase Field for the top of the eighth. Now the left fielder. So out of the pen for the Diamondbacks, Kendall Graveman.
Well, he's been hit pretty hard at times this season, as you see with the big ERA. So this is an important outing for him to get on the right track.
Throws across the diamond, and that's one away as the leadoff man is out in the eighth. Back to the top of the lineup now, Edouard Julien. Base is empty, one away, and we're in the top of the eighth. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2.
It's so hard to slow yourself down when you see that juicy breaking ball, but the most success happens when you try to
finally
right
a pitcher gets
the
one.
Approach.
The throw to first.
Thank God.
Two up, two down here in the top of the eighth. Two outs, base is empty. Now here is Alex Kirilov.
Slider. First slider. Back to the slider.
That's the third, and that's just foul. Swing and a miss, and he chases that one in the dirt. Gets to it on to first. That completes the strikeout, and that'll do it.
There we go.
Back now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, Steven Okert.
Well, walks have certainly been an issue for him this season, so we'll see what kind of command he has.
That one finds the zone, and the count one and two.
Apparently no issue for him at the moment.
And another ball. Minnesota's bullpen with some action. Yoan Duran appears to be getting loose. On the ground at first. Lays out. Oh, it's off his glove. Flip to the pitcher is in time.
Yeah,
and
out,
even
though,
with his
damn
speed, they get the out. Here's Ketel Marte.
Damn.
Looking to get the tying run on base.
Rip fuck, on right at him, too.
In plenty of time to first, they get the out on Marte. Christian Walker, the next to hit.
Yeah, home run.
Wouldn't chase that time.
Get home run, Christian.
And a good eye there.
That was a good
pitch,
too.
Waiting to hit for the D-backs. Swing and a miss. He was late. Strike two.
I think he was sitting off speed there.
Got it looking. And he did not like the call. So one.
Get back in.
And welcome back to the ballpark. We go to the ninth. Now the third baseman, Royce Lewis. He swings and fouls one off. They tried to get him to chase on a slider.
I went up. I wonder if that's going to change anything.
Bounce to the right side. Slings to first, and they get the leadoff man in the ninth. Byron Buxton, the next twin up to hit. Into center and a base hit.
Feel good speed though. I gotta put the sinker to good use.
The pitch. Buxton on the run.
Mm-hmm.
Crowd locked in right now. One run game here in the ninth. That pitch just misses the inside corner.
I'm sorry,
two balls, two strikes. And the right-hander deals. That one off the mark, and it's 3-2.
At this point in the game, you cannot issue free passes. He's going to have to challenge this.
Oh, now this one's high and deep. Way back there. On its way. Gone.
Oh, that's the game.
His 16th.
I can't even get one right. I'm going to get three all of a sudden.
It's 3-0. Chris, he's homered in back-to-back games now.
Yep, seeing the ball well, and he's got his timing locked in. He's looking pretty dangerous at the dish right now.
Suarez, throw to first, in time.
To be fair, and I probably Correa shouldn't retired. Have pitched Graveman.
That space is empty. Max Kepler at the plate. Base is empty, two away, but two runs are in here at the top of the ninth. On the ground right
but
side.
I didn't want to go.
He takes it himself for the bag, and that'll do it. But the Twins bring in two on the homer. It's now 3. Back now as they hand the ball to a fresh arm to start the bottom of the ninth. Yoan Duran.
He's having a ton of success facing left-handed hitters this season, so this seems like a smart move to turn to him with a lefty at the plate.
Singy, that's a start.
Yeah, as soon as that ball got through, I could see down in the dugout, guys pumping their fists. They know that they got a chance in this ballgame.
So they're making the move for a bat off the bench. Jake McCarthy, a runner at first for him, nobody out. Looks like we've got a substitution at first. Coming in as a pinch runner, Garrett Hampson. Here's the pitch, runner on the goal. Next offering is foul back. The D-backs trailing by 3. We're in the last half of the ninth inning. Rudder goes again. Battling here as he fouls it away.
I'm in some gas.
Move to first. Hampson gets back easily.
When the leadoff man gets on, you want to minimize the threat by playing sound defense. Hopefully the pitcher can get a ball on the ground and they can roll him up for 2.
Rudder goes again. And he grounds one to the right side. Gets it to first. One out, bottom of the ninth. He's 2 outs away. Now it's the shortstop, Geraldo Perdomo. Man at second. Swing and a high fly ball left field. And puts the squeeze on that one. And there's 2 away. And Eugenio Suarez up to hit now. Torrey Lovello making a move for a new.
Hold on.
Bat Brandon Drury looking for a 2-out hit with a runner in scoring position. Kicks and deals. Sends it to center, and that's gonna do it. And that'll wrap it up.
Shut out by the Twins. Damn.
Behind some great pitching and defense.
This is a good game. 3-0. It's not bad. Considering it was 1-0 through the whole thing.
That's not bad. In these close games.
The shutout
not
in this one.
Not bad.
Our final score.
All right. Thank you guys so much for watching. I appreciate it. I will see you all next time. Bye.